Hello everyone and welcome to a new Elden Ring video. Today I have for you an Ash of War that I am very sure you're gonna love. Just look what you can do with it. This is the most unique Ash of War that you can have in this game, and this will make your enemies fly. And when I tell you that, I mean they can really fly. Just look at this. It's fun, it's strong, and it's definitely something that you'll need to hunt those big giants on the map. I'm gonna show how you can defeat those. And I will just put this Ash of War on a regular weapon. I know it's upgraded, but it's not something one of the best weapons in the game. It's just a regular, I think it's a spear or something like that. I'm gonna show you the stats for this. Just look at the damage that I dealt right there. 2.2k damage, only with this simple Ash of War. Too bad I have those soldiers that are just keep attacking me. And as you already know, if you are a subscriber for more than 1 week, I cannot dodge the hits. I'm not the best player in matter of fighting, I'm the best in not the best. I just try to be the best in matter of finding items for you and showcase you all the items. I'm gonna show you, probably on my channel I want to show you every single good item that you can have, rare, secret, boss, location, everything. Now I just try to my enemy. This is my enemy, if you don't know this bird. I always test my weapons on this bird, because this thing is so complex. It can fly in the air, it can throw me in the air, but with this Ash of War I just think it was way much easier. Also, I just want to go here into the underground region of the capital, and if you don't know, this enemy, it's pretty tough. It's hard to defeat him. But with this Ash of War again, just look at the damage that you can do, the damage that you can inflict with this Ash of War. It's so crazy. And trust me, this is not about the weapon. This is mostly about that Ash of War, because that Ash of War gonna put down your enemies. Just look at this. Bro, it's ended so fun. Imagine this in PvP. I know, usually I don't record videos in PvP. Probably I'm gonna do that in the future, I'm not sure. If you want to see that, probably I'm gonna make a series of player versus player with some weapons, but for now I just want to showcase you and to show you how you can get them and how you can use them. Easy as that. You know what, let's just go to not waste more time, and let me just show you how you can get this weapon. Not the hardest weapon to get, not the easiest, it's a medium. Will take some like 10 minutes in total, something like that. First you have to make your way to this church, to the Bellum church. But if you are a total beginner and if you don't know how to be there, don't worry, I got you. From the first step, you'll have to go to the path that I'm gonna show. You'll have two different options, but first reach the Church of Ella, then go to the Gatefort ruins. Then here you'll have to make a decision at the Stormhill shack. If you are a total beginner, you have to defeat Godric, or you have the option to bypass the Stormveil Castle. That it's only up to you what you want to do. The simple way is to go right here to bypass the Stormveil Castle. This will be the path to go to that location. Then you have to reach the Liurnia Lakes. You have to go in the middle of the lake and just cross it, because now we have to reach another region. I'm going to show you exactly how we can get there. So basically this is going to be just running with your horse. Here is the Raya Lucaria Academy. If you are here for the first time, you don't have to enter, but I told you have to go to that Bellum church. The easiest way to go to the Bellum church, in my opinion, it will be to a Kraken wall right over here, to the ravine, I hope I pronounced the name right, to the ravine site of grace. You have to move a little bit further and go on the right side, right here. On the right side you're gonna see a path on that little hill that you can climb, and you're gonna go to this church, to the Bellum church. Now after you just reach that church, all you have to do is to follow me into the second part of this video, because now we're gonna take the horse and I'm gonna just go to the location where you have to be. Take this site of grace if you don't have it already. I didn't have it because I'm in the new game plus, and yes, you have to get your site of grace again. Now, very important, go into the night time. So rest at that fireplace and wait until it will be night time, because you have to defeat a knight that is available only and only in night time. Let me show you where we have to go. Just go back a little bit into those ruins, and you're gonna see a big black knight that is just standing out there. I had to change my sword because I died first time, and if you don't know how I defeat this guy, I use my blasphemous sword. That is the sword that you can get from Rykard, the serpent boss, but you can use it with your best armament, with your best weapons. It doesn't matter which one you wanna use. It was not a hard fight, but this knight just ran away from me. Just look at him. I have to chase him. Oh bro, don't be so, this is so aggressive, but it was a pretty easy fight. Then, as a bonus, you're gonna get also a weapon. This is a bonus that I like to give you in my videos. If you already saw my video when because I released a video with this weapon, now you already know how to get the Ash of War. But if not, now you just find yourself a new weapon in your inventory. This is the sword that I used. And now let me show you the stats of that Ash of War. Here we go. The Giant Hunt is the name. You can use it on colossal weapons, spears and twin blades. Looks pretty awesome, and I told you, it can just make your enemies fly. Again, for sure they're gonna fly, at least the small ones. Let me just show you again. Okay, let's put it on a weapon, on this one. I told you I'm gonna put it on that spear, but later on you're gonna see that I put it on another spear just to test it. I want to test more and more weapons, not only one. This spear is just good looking. It's pretty tough, it's good, but again, not the best in the game. Lock on your target. This will be the move. And lock on your target, like I just told you. You have to be pretty close. Not very, but pretty close. And like, oh bro, don't be aggressive, because you wanna, okay, nice. I just made you fly. Just look at this scene. Not this one, the second one. Just look at that witch, how it can fly without a broom. Oh, 3-4 feet in the air. 5. That's it. What do you think? Tell me in the comments. I really like it. I really enjoy it. If you don't know me and my channel, I'm so glad to have you here. I really am. I release daily videos in Elden Ring, but also in other type of games, a lot of games. I show you guides, I show you, I don't know, a lot of things. So I post daily a lot of videos. If you love me and not me, if you love my work, you can hit that like button, subscribe, share, press the notification bell, and definitely I'm gonna see you very soon. Be safe, and don't forget, important is to press that notification bell, because I have prepared for you more than 20 videos by now. Yes, I keep doing them, and I have a stack of 20 new videos that I want to post this day. So let's see when I have the time, but daily you're gonna see at least 2 videos in Elden Ring on my channel. I think that's it's a pretty high number. Oh doggy, come here. Okay, bye.